Dear friends in Christ, on this most holy night, when our Lord Jesus Christ passed from death to life, the Church invites her children throughout the world to come together in vigil and prayer. This is the Passover of the Lord, when we venerate him in the mystery of his death and resurrection. Through the celebration of the Paschal mystery in word and sacrament, he renews our faith and hope and gives us a share in his victory over death and in his eternal life with our most gracious God. Let us pray. Almighty God, we share in the light of your glory through your Son, the light of the world. Sanctify this new fire and inflame us with this new hope. Purify our minds by this Easter celebration and bring us to the feast of eternal light. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Christ yesterday and today, the beginning and the end, the Alpha, the Omega. By his holy and glorious wounds, may Christ our Lord guard us and keep us
Stand near this marvelous and holy flame. Pray with me to God the Almighty for the grace to sing the worthy praise of this great light. Through Jesus Christ, his Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with him in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
It is truly right and good, always and everywhere, with our whole heart and mind and voice to praise you, the invisible, almighty, and eternal God, and your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. For he is the true Paschal Lamb, who at the feast of the Passover paid for us the debt of Adam's sin, and by his blood delivered your faithful people. This is the night when you brought our fathers, the children of Israel, out of bondage in Egypt, and led them through the Red Sea on dry land. This is the night when all who believe in Christ are delivered from the gloom of sin and are restored to grace and holiness of life. This is the night when Christ broke the bonds of death and hell and rose victorious from the grave. How wonderful and beyond our knowing, O God, is your mercy and loving kindness to us, that to redeem a slave you gave a son. How holy is this night, when wickedness is put to flight, and sin is washed away. It restores innocence to the fallen, and joy to those who mourn. It casts out pride and hatred, and brings peace and concord. How blessed is this night, when earth and heaven are joined, and man is reconciled to God. Holy Father, accept our evening sacrifice, the offering of this candle in your honor. May it shine continually to drive away all darkness. May Christ, the morning star who knows no setting, find it ever burning. He who gives his light to all creation, and who lives and reigns forever and
let us hear the record of God's saving deeds in history, how God saved the people in ages past, and let us pray that our God will bring each of us to the fullness of redemption.
In the first lesson, we hear of Israel's deliverance at the Red Sea. As Pharaoh drew near, the Israelites looked back, and there were the Egyptians advancing on them. In great fear, the Israelites cried out to the Lord. They said to Moses, "Was it because there were no graves in Egypt that you have taken us away to die in the wilderness? What have you done to us, bringing us out of Egypt? Is this not the very thing we told you? Let us alone and let us serve the Egyptians? For it would have been better to serve the Egyptians than to die in the wilderness." But Moses said to the people, "Do not be afraid. Stand firm and see the deliverance that the Lord will accomplish for you today. For the Egyptians whom you see today, you shall never see again. The Lord will fight for you, and you only have to keep still." Then the Lord said to Moses, "Why do you cry out to me? Tell the Israelites to go forward. But you lift up your staff and stretch out your hand over the sea and divide it, that the Israelites may go into the sea on dry ground. Then I will harden the hearts of the Egyptians so that they will go in after them. And so I will gain glory for myself over Pharaoh, and over all his armies, his chariots, and his chariot drivers. And the Egyptians shall know that I am the Lord when I have gained glory for myself over Pharaoh, his chariots, and his chariot drivers." The angel of God, who was going before the Israelite army, moved out and went behind them. and the pillar of cloud moved from in front of them and took its place behind them. It came between the army of Egypt and the army of Israel. And so the cloud was there with the darkness, and it lit up the night. One did not come near the other all night. Then Moses stretched out his hand over the sea. The Lord drove the sea back by a strong east wind all night and turned the sea into dry land, and the waters were divided. The Israelites went into the sea on dry ground, the waters forming a wall for them on their right and on their left. The Egyptians pursued and went into the sea after them, all of Pharaoh's horses, chariots, and chariot drivers. At the morning watch, the Lord in the pillar of fire and cloud looked down upon the Egyptian army and threw the Egyptian army into panic. He clogged their chariot wheels so that they turned with great difficulty. The Egyptians said, "Let us flee from the Israelites, for the Lord is fighting for them against Egypt." Then the Lord said to Moses, "Stretch out your hand over the sea so that the water may come back upon the Egyptians, upon their chariots and chariot drivers." So Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and at dawn the sea was returned to its normal depth. As the Egyptians fled before it, the Lord tossed the Egyptians into the sea. The waters returned and covered the chariots and the chariot drivers, the entire army of Pharaoh that had followed them into the sea. Not one of them remained. But the Israelites walked on dry ground through the sea, the waters forming a wall for them on their right and on their left. Thus the Lord saved Israel that day from the Egyptians, and Israel saw the Egyptians dead on the seashore. Israel saw the great work that the Lord did against the Egyptians, so the people feared the Lord and believed in the Lord and in his servant Moses.
Yeah.
Let us pray. O God, whose wonderful deeds of old shine forth even to our own day, you once delivered by the power of your mighty arm your chosen people from slavery under Pharaoh, to be a sign for us of the salvation of all nations by the water of baptism. Grant that all the peoples of the earth may be numbered among the offspring of Abraham and rejoice in the inheritance of Israel. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
In the second lesson, we hear of the salvation freely offered to all. Everyone who thirsts, come to the waters. And you that have no money, come, buy and eat. Come, buy wine and milk without money and without price. Why do you spend your money for that which is not bread, and your labor for that which does not satisfy? Listen carefully to me, and eat what is good, and delight yourselves in rich food. Incline your ear and come to me. Listen, so that you may live. I will make with you an everlasting covenant, my steadfast, sure love for David. See, I made him a witness to the peoples, a leader and a commander for the peoples. See, you shall call nations that you do not know, and nations that do not know you shall run to you, because the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, for he has glorified you. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call upon him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake their way, and the unrighteous their thoughts. Let them return to the Lord, that he may have mercy on them, and to our God, for he will abundantly pardon. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways, says the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. For as the rain and the snow come down from heaven and do not return there until they have watered the earth, making it bring forth and sprout, giving seed to the sower and bread to the eater, so shall my word be that goes out from my mouth. It shall not return to me empty, but it shall accomplish that which I purpose, and succeed in the thing for which I sent it.
Let us pray. O God, you have created all things by the power of your word, and you renew the earth by your spirit. Give now the water of life to those who thirst for you, that they may bring forth abundant fruit in your glorious kingdom. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
In the third lesson, we hear of the Valley of Dry Bones. The hand of the Lord came upon me, and he brought me out by the Spirit of the Lord and set me down in the middle of a valley. It was full of bones. He led me all around them. There were very many lying in the valley, and they were very dry. He said to me, "Mortal, can these bones live?" I answered, "O Lord God, you know." Then he said to me, "Prophesy to these bones and say to them, O dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. Thus says the Lord God to these bones, I will cause breath to enter you, and you shall live. I will lay sinews on you, and will cause flesh to come upon you, and cover you with skin, and put breath in you, and you shall live. And you shall know that I am the Lord." So I prophesied, as I had been commanded. And as I prophesied, suddenly there was a noise, a rattling, and the bones came together, bone to its bone. I looked, and there were sinews on them, and flesh had come upon them, and skin had covered them. But there was no breath in them. Then he said to me, "Prophesy to the breath. Prophesy, mortal, and say to the breath, Thus says the Lord God, Come from the four winds, O breath, and breathe upon these slain, that they may live." I prophesied as he commanded me, and the breath came into them, and they lived and stood on their feet, a vast multitude. Then he said to me, "Mortal, these bones are the whole house of Israel. They say, Our bones are dried up, and our hope is lost. We are cut off completely. Therefore, prophesy and say to them, Thus says the Lord God, I am going to open your graves and bring you up from your graves, O my people, and I will bring you back to the land of Israel. And you shall know that I am the Lord when I open your graves and bring you up from your graves, O my people. I will put my spirit within you, and you shall live. And I will place you on your own soil. Then you shall know that I, the Lord, have spoken and will act, says the Lord."
not let my enemies triumph over me. O Lord, my God, I cried out to you, and you restored me to brought me up, O Lord, from the dead. You restored my life as I was going down to the grave. Sing to the Lord, you servants of His. Give thanks for the remembrance of His.
Let us pray. Almighty God, by the Passover of your Son, you have brought us out of sin into righteousness and out of death into life. Grant to those who are sealed by your Holy Spirit the will and the power to proclaim you to all the world. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Candidate for holy baptism will now be presented.
We present Luke Rob Wallace to receive the sacrament of baptism.
Luke, do you desire to be baptized?
I do.
Do you renounce Satan and all the spiritual forces of wickedness that rebel against God?
I renounce them.
Do you renounce the evil powers of this world which corrupt and destroy the creatures of God? Do you renounce all sinful desires that draw you from the love of God?
I renounce them.
Do you turn to Jesus Christ and accept Him as your Savior?
I do.
Do you put your whole trust in His grace and love?
I do.
Do you promise to follow and obey Him as your Lord?
I do.
As you're able, will the rest of you please stand? Will you who witness these vows do all in your power to support this person in his life in Christ?
We will.
Through the Paschal mystery, dear friends, we are buried with Christ by baptism into his death and raised with him to newness of life. I call upon you, therefore, now that our Lenten observance is ended, to renew with this person about to be baptized the solemn promises and vows of holy baptism, by which we renounce Satan and all evil works and promise to serve God faithfully in the Holy Catholic Church.
Do you reaffirm your renunciation of evil and renew your commitment to Jesus Christ?
I do.
Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Will you continue in the apostles' teaching and fellowship, in the breaking of bread and in the prayers?
I will, with God's help.
Will you persevere in resisting evil, and whenever you fall into sin, repent and return to the Lord?
I will, with God's help.
Will you proclaim by word and example the good news of God in Christ?
I will, with God's help.
Will you seek and serve Christ in all persons, loving your neighbor as yourself?
I will, with God's help.
Will you strive for justice and peace among all people and respect the dignity of every human being?
I will, with God's help.
Thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
We thank you, Almighty God, for the gift of water. Over it, the Holy Spirit moved in the beginning of creation. Through it, you led the children of Israel out of their bondage in Egypt into the land of promise. In it, your Son Jesus received the baptism of John and was anointed by the Holy Spirit as the Messiah, the Christ, to lead us through his death and resurrection from the bondage of sin into everlasting life. We thank you, gracious God, for the water of baptism. In it we are buried with Christ in his death. By it we share in his resurrection. Through it we are reborn by the Holy Spirit. Therefore, in joyful obedience to Christ, we bring into his fellowship those who come to him in faith, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Now sanctify this water, we pray you, by the power of your Holy Spirit, that those who here are cleansed from sin and born again may continue forever in the risen life of Jesus Christ, our Savior. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit be all honor and glory, now and forever.
Amen.
Luke, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Luke, you are sealed by the Holy Spirit in baptism and marked as Christ's own forever. Luke, receive the light of Christ and carry it into the world. Gracious God, we thank you that by water and the Holy Spirit, you have bestowed upon this your servant the forgiveness of sin and have raised him to the new life of grace. Sustain him, O Lord, in your Holy Spirit. Give him an inquiring and discerning heart, the courage to will and to persevere, and a spirit to know and to love you, and the gift of joy and wonder in all your works.
Amen.
Let us welcome the newly baptized.
We receive you into the household of God. Confess the faith of Christ crucified, proclaim his resurrection, and share with us in the eternal
priesthood. Thank you. We give thanks, O gracious God.
For your mercy endures forever.
Who loved us from all eternity.
For your mercy endures forever.
Who does great wonders.
For your mercy endures forever.
Whose excellent wisdom made the heavens.
For your mercy endures forever.
Who laid out the earth above the waters.
For your mercy endures forever.
Who has made great lights.
For your mercy endures forever.
The sun to rule the day.
For your mercy endures forever.
The moon and the stars to govern the night.
For your mercy endures forever.
Who gives food to all flesh.
For your mercy endures
called Abraham and Sarah from Haran.
For your mercy endures forever.
Who brought out Israel from Egypt.
For your mercy endures forever.
With a mighty hand and a stretched out arm.
For your mercy endures forever.
Who divided the Red Sea in two parts.
For your mercy endures forever.
And made Israel to go through the midst of it.
For your mercy endures forever.
Who led the people through the wilderness.
For your mercy endures forever.
Who remembered us when we were in trouble.
For your mercy endures forever.
Who for us and for our salvation came down from heaven.
For your mercy endures forever.
And was incarnate by the Holy Spirit of the Virgin Mary and was made man.
For your mercy endures forever.
Who by his cross and passion has redeemed the world.
For your mercy endures forever.
And has washed us from our sins in his own blood.
For your mercy endures forever.
Who on the third day rose from the dead.
For your mercy endures forever.
And has given us the victory.
For your mercy endures forever.
Who ascended up on high.
For your mercy endures forever.
And open wide for us the everlasting doors.
For your mercy endures forever.
Who sits on the right hand of God.
For your mercy endures forever.
And lives to make intercession for us.
For your mercy endures forever.
our God is a merciful God.
For your mercy endures forever.
We offer all glory, honor, and worship, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, world without end.
Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Alleluia. Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Alleluia. Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God, who made this most holy night to shine with the glory of the Lord's resurrection, stir up in your church that spirit of adoption which is given to us in baptism, that we, being renewed both in body and mind, may worship you in sincerity and truth. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
A reading from Paul's letter to the Romans. Do you not know that all of us who have been baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? Therefore, we have been buried with him by baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, so we too might walk in newness of life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we will certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. We know that our old self was crucified with him, so that the body of sin might be destroyed, and we might no longer be enslaved to sin. For whoever has died is freed from sin. But if we have died with Christ, we believe that we will also live with him. We know that Christ, being raised from the dead, will never die again. Death no longer has dominion over him. The death he died to sin once for all. But the life he lives to God. So you also must consider yourselves dead to sin and alive to God in Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord.
Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. Matthew.
Glory to you, Christ.
After the Sabbath, as the first day of the week was dawning, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to see the tomb. And suddenly there was a large earthquake, for an angel of the Lord descending from heaven came and rolled back the stone and sat on it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothing white as snow. For fear of him, the guards shook and became like dead men. But the angel said to the women, "Do not be afraid. I know that you are looking for Jesus who was crucified. He is not here, for he has been raised, as he said. Come, see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples, 'He has been raised from the dead, and indeed he is going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him.' This is my message for you." So they left the tomb quickly with fear and great joy and ran to tell his disciples. Suddenly Jesus met them and said, "Greetings." And they came to him, took hold of his feet, and worshipped him. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee. There they will see me." The Gospel of the Lord.
In the name of the risen Christ. Amen. The beginning of resurrection is like the first glimmer of light at the edge of the darkest hour. It is good that we began this night in darkness, because resurrection always begins there, in darkness, the seeds of new beginning planted in the debris of something lost. Two physical sensations accompany resurrection. The first is a feeling of lightness, as whatever weight we have been carrying is taken from us, sometimes gradually, sometimes all at once. You know, in all the stories of Jesus' resurrection, there features this enormous stone that seals the tomb where Jesus lay, and the women who have risen to anoint Jesus' body with the customary funeral oils, in one version, worry aloud, "Who will remove the stone for us?" And in some versions, by the time they get there, it's already gone, or in the best version of all, the one we heard tonight, there's this earthquake and an angel appears, moves the stone and sits on it. So consider the stone in your life and what it would feel like to have it go away, taken from you by some angel or harbinger of new life. Whenever that happens, We breathe differently, and we walk lighter on our feet. We wake up one morning, and whatever pain or anger, grief or stuckness that has sat like a weight on our chest is gone, if not completely, significantly so. Whenever that stone is removed, we feel alive again. Not in the same way as before, but no longer defined anymore solely by that stone. The second sensation of resurrection is that of energy and momentum. It's not as if we're being carried exactly. We're still the ones deciding when and how to move. But there's a wind at our backs now and a new motivation that makes our actions fruitful and confident. Remember how in the resurrection accounts the women walk toward the tomb with heavy hearts. But after they encounter Jesus, they run. They run. Yes, they are still afraid, but they also feel joy. Joy and urgency. And it's like that for us in resurrection. Joy accompanying our fear. Joy on top of loss. And we discover energy we haven't felt for a long time. It's like that feeling you have after you've been sick for a while. And first there's a relief when you just don't feel the pain. And then energy coming back. Now these sensations of lightness and energy are wonderful. But they're not as easy to embrace as we might imagine. First, we must remember their context, which is a death. Resurrection follows death. And we might mistake at first that lightness and energy for harbingers of a life that is actually gone. And that life is no longer available to us, which catches us off guard. When we realize that we actually only have two options now, one is staying dead in some way, and the other is moving forward, which is good, but it requires something of us, something new. In resurrection, God gives us new life, but we also have to choose it. We have to choose the new life. The wise Quaker educator and author Parker Palmer wrote just yesterday a post that was up on the internet, and he titled it An Upside Down Easter Meditation. And in it, he describes how he, years ago, came across a book by the Guatemalan poet Julia Esquivel entitled Threatened with Resurrection. And these words had a great impact on him because at the time, he was experiencing a kind of death in life in the form of a deep clinical depression. And while he had been taught all of his life to believe that it was actually death that was threatening and life comforting, he realized that it was actually death that was comfortable. And resurrection, this hope of new life that was threatening. When I was depressed, he confessed, nobody expected anything of me. Nor did I expect anything of myself. I was exempt from life's demands and risks. But if I were to find new life, who knows what daunting tasks I might be required to take on. So it is. When resurrection stirs, understandably, we hesitate. We might even pull back for fear of what life might expect from us, which is a good reason to be here tonight. You see, we get to practice proclaiming resurrection in the dark. And you only have 1,000 people around you as witnesses. So I invite you this night to identify the place inside you awakening, where the stone is being lifted and energy returning. Say goodbye tonight to the life you must leave behind. Say goodbye to the comfort of death and choose the new life that God sets before you. Choose it right now and live from this moment forward as if it were real and as if it were yours, so that by tomorrow morning when we gather again to proclaim resurrection, it will feel like your new Easter clothes made for you, this new life that God has prepared and in which Jesus waits to walk with you as your abiding companion and friend. Amen.
Alleluia, alleluia, Christ is risen. The peace of Christ be always with you.
And also with you. Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia.
Good evening and welcome to Washington National Cathedral. Please be seated. I'm intrigued with Bishop Budde's notion that we sort of have a step ahead of the people coming tomorrow morning. So we'll show them what's what when they get here. I'm glad that you have chosen to be with us this evening, and we want to welcome you on Bishop Mariann Budde's behalf, on my behalf, on the behalf of everyone who's part of our life and ministry. I want to welcome you and encourage you to enter fully into the life and worship of this faith community. Whoever you are, wherever you find yourself on the journey of faith, you are welcome at God's table. The ushers will show you how to make your way forward to the communion stations, and as you come forward, if you decide you'd rather have a blessing instead, please cross your arms across your chest, and the people at the communion station will know to give you a blessing instead. But you are welcome, and we invite you to join us. Easter is the center of our life as followers of Jesus, and it is the most glorious and holiest day that we have in the year. And as we gather, we are thankful for God's abundant gifts and God's deep generosity to us. And now we come to that part in the service where we respond to God's generosity with our own giving so that we can support the ministry done in the world in Christ's name. So let us with gladness present the offerings and the oblations of our life and our labor to God. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We give them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
We praise you and we bless you, holy and gracious God, source of life abundant. From before time you made ready the creation. Your spirit moved over the deep and brought all things into being. Sun, moon, and stars, earth, winds, and waters, and every living thing. You made us in your image and taught us to walk in your ways, but we rebelled against you and wandered far away. And yet, as a mother cares for her children, you would not forget us. Time and again, you called us to live in the fullness of your love. And so this day, we join with saints and angels in the chorus of praise that rings through eternity, lifting our voice to magnify you as we sing. And praise to you, holy and living God, to deliver us from the power of sin and death and to reveal the riches of your grace. You looked with favor upon Mary, your willing servant, that she might conceive and bear a son, Jesus, the Holy Child of God. Living among us, Jesus loved us. He broke bread with outcasts and sinners, healed the sick, and proclaimed good news to the poor. He yearned to draw all the world to himself, yet we were heedless of his call to walk in love. Then the time came for him to complete upon the cross the sacrifice of his life and to be glorified by you. On the night before he died for us, Jesus was at table with his friends. He took bread, gave thanks to you, broke it, and gave it to them and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." As supper was ending, Jesus took the cup of wine. Again, he gave thanks to you, gave it to them, and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Now, gathered at your table, O God of all creation, and remembering Christ, crucified and risen, who was and is and is to come, we offer to you our gifts of bread and wine and ourselves a living sacrifice. Pour out your Spirit upon these gifts that they may be the body and blood of Christ.
Breathe your Spirit over the whole earth and make us
a new creation. The body of Christ given for the world you have made. In the fullness of time, bring us with Mary, the mother of Jesus, Peter, Paul, and all your saints from every tribe and language and people and nation to feast at the banquet prepared from the foundation of the world. Through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, to you be honor, glory, and praise forever and ever.
Amen.
As we join our prayers with those of the Church Universal, so we say each in our own language the prayer that Jesus has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The gifts of God for the people of God.
The body of Christ, the bread of heaven, the blood of Christ, the cup of salvation.
Amen.
Oops. Body of Christ.
Let us pray. God of abundance, you have fed us with the bread of life and cup of salvation. You have united us with Christ and one another, and you have made us one with all your people in heaven and on earth. Now send us forth in the power of your Spirit, that we may proclaim your redeeming love to the world and continue forever in the risen life of Christ. Amen.
God the Father, who raised Christ Jesus from the dead, continually show us loving kindness. Amen. God the Son, victor over sin and death, grant us a share in the joy of his resurrection.
Amen.
God the Spirit, giver of life and peace, renew our hearts in love.
Amen.
May Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, continue to bless us now and forevermore. Amen.
Let us go forth in the name of Christ. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thank you.